Now, I would like to brief our audience about the Sage Group. Sage Group is a leading business group of Central India. Its presence exists in the area of real estate, education, electrical infrastructure, and industry. A synonym of trust and quality, the group counts as the best business house of Bhopal, which has a history of integrity, innovation, and addressing the needs of today's time for striving transformation in the lives of customers across the nation. With an abundance of awards and recognition, the Sage Group is devoted to serving superlative. The group has an admirable track record, a solid experience, and a proven strength on delivering norms across its full spectrum of services. The Sage Group is driven to deliver projects on time using world-class management techniques and has uncompromising standards of safety and sustainability. And that is how we are the business house of Central India. Now, I also want to brief about our institution. Sagar Institute of Research and Pharmacy, Bhopal, SIRTP, was established in 2004 to provide quality pharmacy education with an aim to improve and develop better healthcare under the umbrella of Sri Agarwal Technical Education Society. SIRTP is one of the first institute of Bhopal, which is accredited by NBA. The institute also having ISO certification with a state of art infrastructure, faculty members, and facility. It is considered as unique center of excellence at all levels of pharmaceutical education. So with this, I would like to share one video about the Sage Group. Yeah, okay. So I would like to hand over the audience to Mr. M.K. Shukla, who is the director and founder of DCRC Lab, to brief about our audience about this lab. Sir, kindly welcome, sir. Monu, sir.
Yeah, sure. Is my slide is visible, ma'am? Thank you so much, ma'am, and very good afternoon to all of you. I welcome all the participants of DCRC and participants of this webinar, Era of Computer-Aided Drug Design 2021. I welcome to our eminent speaker, Dr. Suren Jain, sir, from Sagar Institute of Research and Technology, Pharmacy, Bhopal, and Dr. Arun Kumar Gupta, sir, from Chameli Devi Institute of Pharmacy, Indore. This is our third virtual webinar on computer-aided drug design due to the COVID-19 pandemic. DCRC is powered by Nayi Subah and it's established in 2020 at Indore, Madhya Pradesh. Nurtured and promoted under the auspicious guidance from the persons of Cheminformatics and Bioinformatics. DCRC is committed to advance the field of in silico drug design and discovery in the central India region. The center has active collaboration with Unicode Soft Corp Private Limited for the development of efficient software and databases. Our objective to empowering people with skills in computer-aided drug design, provide free study materials and softwares, improve drug discovery processes, and making a better tomorrow. Our directed areas are molecular docking, MD simulations, transcriptional signatures, protein comparison, artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning, data mining, binding site detection, network pharmacology, ligand similarity. Our advisory board members are Dr. Kamal Raj Pardasani, Professor, Department of Mathematics, Bioinformatics and Computer Applications, MNIT, Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. Dr. Arun Kumar Gupta, Professor and Principal, Chameli Devi Institute of Pharmacy, Indore, Madhya Pradesh. And Dr. Satish Kumar Sarankar, Principal, Akhil Bharati College of Pharmacy, भोपाल. I welcome to our both eminent speakers and also Professor Surbhi Jain as a moderator and Priyanka Rathore ma'am as a coordinator. Thank you so much to attending this webinar. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Now, as we move forward, it's my privilege to introduce our today's resource person of technical lecture first of this webinar, Dr. Surendra Jain, sir. Dr. Jain, sir, is professor, director in Sagar Institute of Research in Technology Pharmacy. As moved towards his academic profile, sir has completed his PhD from Department of Pharmacy, Shri G.S. Institute of Technology and Science, Indore, in the year 2004. And sir has completed his M.Pharm in Medicinal and Pharmaceutical Chemistry and B.Pharm from Department of Pharmacy, SGS ITS, Indore. Sir is holding a vast teaching and research experience of more than 20 years. Sir has felicitated by enormous awards, received various travel grants, Best Academician Award and various scholarships. Sir is also nominated in various academic bodies like Member Board of Studies in Pharmacy, RGPV, Bhopal. International Journal, subject expert in panel of selection committee for selection of lecturer in various institutes, member Central Executive Committee of APTI. There is a life member of professional bodies like IPA, the Association of Pharmaceutical Teachers of India, the Indian Hospital Association. Sir has various publications in reputed journals, and there are a long list of achievements and awards of sir. So with that note, I would like to invite respected director sir to please address our audience, sir. Sir, please.
Thank you, Surbhi ma'am. Mujhe screen share karne ki permission kar do.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Thank you very much.
Yes, sir. You are too.
Member of organizing committee of today's webinar, Mr. M. K. Shukla, Director, DCRC, for providing me to interact with the participants and students on this webinar, Era of Computer-Aided Drug Design 2021. This is a very brief about computer-aided drug design. And on behalf of Sage Group and Sagar Group of Institution, I would like to thank each and everyone to be present in this particular webinar. My today's topic is Path to Computer-Aided Drug Design. My screen is visible to all?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So as you know that computer has entered in each and every part of our life. Similarly, it has also very important factor in designing of a drug. As in earlier days, the designing of drug took long time, almost 10 to 20 years. But nowadays, because of use of artificial intelligence and molecular modeling software, designing of drug is very fast. You have practically witnessed this thing in last 1 year in 2020. India has developed 2 vaccines for COVID-19 in a very short span of 9 months. So this could be happened because of the use of drug design only. So drug design, it is a inventive process of finding new medications based on the knowledge of a biological target. If we know the biological target in virtual format or in vivo format, we can target our designed molecule and we can get a success within a fraction of minutes. It involves the design of molecules that are complementary in shape and charge to the biomolecular target with which they interact and therefore will bind to it. Life cycle of drug design, we can say traditional life cycle is synthesis, synthetic or natural compounds. Second step is preclinical trial. Third step is clinical trial, and then making a drug. modern drug design, first steps is target selection, identification of target, verification of target and target selection. Second step is lead identification, screen development, high throughput screening and secondary assay methods. Third step is lead optimization, lead exclusion, potency in disease, pharmacokinetic studies, and finally is the conversion of that molecule into a drug. Drug designing, in this we select and design a molecule, should be organic, small molecule. They should be complementary in shape to the target and oppositely charged to biomolecular target. These three basic requirements should be there to design or to convert any organic molecule into a drug. This molecule will interact with target. Target is mostly a protein, as our whole body is made up of protein, and proteins are the only receptors that acts as a receptor in our body. They bind to the target, activates or inhibits the function of a biomolecular such as a protein. Either they activate that particular protein or they inhibit that particular protein to have a positive effect or a negative effect. Drug design frequently but not necessarily relies on computer modeling techniques. This type of modeling is sometimes referred to as a computer-aided drug design. So with the help of computers, available software, we can modulate, we can design a new molecule that can be acted as a drug molecule in future aspects. Mechanism-based drug design. When the disease process is understood at the molecular level and the target molecules are defined, drugs can be designed specifically to interact with the target molecule in such a way as to disrupt the disease. अगर हमें डिजीज के बारे में पता है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल डायबिटीज, एंड इन प्रोसेस ऑफ अ पर्सन इज सफरिंग फ्रॉम डायबिटीज, फ्यू प्रोटीन्स आर इन्वॉल्व, फ्यू रिसेप्टर्स आर इन्वॉल्व. इफ यू नो द नेचर ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर रिसेप्टर, वी नो द हाइपोथेटिकल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ दैट रिसेप्टर, वी कैन डिजाइन ए मॉलिक्यूल, टारगेट दोज मॉलिक्यूल्स इनटू दोज रिसेप्टर्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ मॉलिक्यूलर मॉडलिंग सॉफ्टवेयर, एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस वी कैन डिजाइन ए न्यू मॉलिक्यूल. CAD represent computational methods and resources that are used to facilitate the design and discovery of new therapeutic solutions. Now, how we can introduce or we can know about computer-aided drug design. Drug design with the help of computers may be used at any of the following stages of the drug discovery. First is hit identification using virtual screening, structure or ligand-based design. Hit to lead optimization of affinity and selectivity, structure-based design, QSAR, lead optimization of other pharmaceutical properties while maintaining affinity. Now, what are the objectives of the CAD, computer-aided drug design? To change from random screening against disease assays, natural products, synthetic chemicals, to rational drug design and testing, speed up screening process, efficient screening, de novo designs, integration of testing into design process, fail drug fast, remove hopeless ones as early as possible. With the help of this, we can remove the outliers which are not fitting in our process. So elimination process is very important or very, very important process in drug designing. What we are doing, we are eliminating the useless molecules which are not putting their efforts in targeting that particular receptor. Types of drug design. First is ligand-based drug design. Second is structure-based drug design. Ligand-based drug design relies on knowledge of other molecules that bind to the biological targets of the interest. Second, used to derive a pharmacophore model that defines the minimum necessary structural characteristics a molecule must possess in order to bind to the target. We should know the ligand or we should know the receptor. For to that particular receptor, we should have any kind of ligand or the molecule. A ligand, we can say a molecule which mimic the exactly same as available molecules. So when we identify that particular ligand that it superimposes on our receptor site, that will directly give you the kind of biological activity we require. ligand-based drug designs, a model of the biological target may be built based on the knowledge of what binds to it, and this model in turns may be used to design new molecular entities that interact with the targets. Alternatively, a quantitative structure activity relationship in which a correlation between calculated properties of molecules and their experimentally designed biological activities may be derived. QSAR is one of the methods of computer aided design in which quantitative derivation of biological activity and physicochemical properties of that molecules are derived. And on the basis of this QSAR analysis, we can predict the activity of new analogs that we have designed. Structure-based drug design, X-ray crystallography, and NMR spectroscopy. It relies on knowledge of the three-dimensional structure of the biological target obtained through X-ray crystallography and second nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy. Structure-based drug design, if an experimental structure of a target is not available, it may be possible to create a homology model of the target based on the experimental structure of a related protein. Homology modeling, also known as comparative modeling of protein, refers to constructing an atom resolution model of the target and an experimental three-dimensional structure of a related homolog protein, the template. This is known as template. Using the structure of the biological target, candidate drug means the molecule to which we are trying to convert into a drug. A candidate target that are predicted to bind with high affinity and selectivity to the target may be designed using interactive graphics, intelligence of a medicinal chemist, various automated computational procedures may be used to suggest new drug candidates. What kind of methods we are using in computer-aided drug design? First is virtual screening. The first method is identification of a new ligand for a given receptor by searching large database of 3D structure of small molecule to find those fitting and binding pockets of the receptor using fast approximate docking programs. Second is de novo design of new ligands. In this method, ligand molecules are built up within the constraints of binding pocket by assembling small pieces in a stepwise manner. These pieces can be either individual atoms or molecular fragments. The key advantage of such a method is that novel structure can be suggested. Third is optimization of known ligand. By evaluating proposed analogs within the binding cavity. Binding site identification now, it is the first step in structure-based design. It relies on identification of concave surfaces on the protein that can accommodate drug-sized molecules that also possesses appropriate hotspot. Hotspots, they are hydrophobic surface, hydrogen bonding sites that drives ligand binding. Docking and scoring. Docking attempt to find the best matching between two molecules. We dock molecules, either two molecules together or one molecule on target sites to match the molecules. It includes finding the right key for the lock. To place a ligand, a small molecule, into the binding site of a receptor in the manners appropriate for optimal interaction with the receptor. To evaluate the ligand-receptor interactions in a way that may discriminate the experimentally observed mode from others and estimate the binding affinity. Components of docking, pre and or during docking, representation of receptor binding sites in ligands. During docking, sampling of configuration space of the ligand-receptor complex. And third is during docking and scoring. Evaluation of ligand receptor interactions. Advantages of CAD. Very important advantage is time. We can reduce the time of designing of a drug. Cost, definitely cost is a very important factor. We can reduce the cost also. We will get accurate results, information about the disease. We fully know the information about the disease. Screening is reduced, multiple screening is reduced with the help of CAD. Database screening should be there and less manpower is required. Manpower requirement is very less in case of CAD. Categories of software that are available to for drug design personnels, they can use these softwares to design a new molecule. Databases and draw tools, molecular modeling and homology modeling, binding site prediction and docking, ligand design screening, QSAR, binding free energy estimation, and ADME toxicity. Zinc database, Zinc 15 database, CMBL database, JCAM for Excel, protein data bank, PDB, binding MOED, PDB bind, Stitch, SMBD. You'll happy to know that the PDB, protein data bank, is with SIRT Pharmacy. We have Schrodinger from USA software license version with us, in which protein data bank is they have given free of cost. Draw tools, CamDraw, Marvin Sketch, ACD Cam Sketch, Marvin Molecule Editor and Viewers, Cam Writers, UCSF, Chimera, Pymol. Most of the softwares, the unlicensed versions are available online to download for free uses, but they have given limited access to work for. If you want to use maximum out of that particular software, you have to take a licensed version. Molecular modeling softwares, CHARM, Gromex, Umber, SwissPerm, CHARM GUI, charming.org, Swiss Light Chain. Homology modeling, Modeler, iTasser, Lomset, Swiss Model Respiratory, and Robeta. Binding site predictions with the help of these softwares, MatSumo, Kaver, FindSight, SCPDB, Pocketome, Pocket Enamine Database, 3D Ligand Site, MetaPocket, and Pocket NO8. Docking softwares, we AutoDock, Dock, Gold, SwissDock, Docking Server, OneKing, and iGemDock softwares are available. Screening softwares, Farmer, Catalyst, PharmaGist, Swiss Similarity, Blaster, Anchor Query, Ligand Scott, and Discovery Studios. Target prediction, mole score antivirals, mole score antibiotics, Swiss target predictions, SEAN, CAMPOT. Ligand design softwares are Gandy, Luri, AutoT and T2, Swiss Bio Isoesters, Vampire, SCPDB Frag, E-Lead, E-Design, and iScreen. Binding free energy estimation by these softwares, QSAR, CQSAR, CLogP, CLogP CMR, MOL-EDB, CAMDB database, OCAM, EGDRAM, and Avogadro. ADME toxicity, Volsurf, GastroPlus, MedCam Studio, AlloGust, Swiss ADME, Metabase, PECT-F, and ToxNet. So these are few softwares I try to include in my presentation. We have Schrodinger software with us. This is licensed version. We can do docking, we can do energy minimization, we can do molecular mechanics and calculations with this. We can simulate our molecule with receptor sites and a maximum things we can do. If anybody is interested in working with us in Schrodinger software, we welcome you all for this. Thank you very much. If you have any query, this is a very short presentation and very brief idea about and the CAD I have given you. Rest will be given by Dr. Arun Gupta sir in next lecture. Thank you. Thank you very much.
For the wonderful presentation and the lecture. Over to you, Shukla sir.
Thank you so much, sir, for sharing your knowledge and experience with the participants. On the behalf of DCRC and the participants of webinar, I want to thank you and hope this webinar and the lecture was fruitful for our participants. And we also providing some freely available softwares, Chimera, AutoDog, AutoDog Vena, and Pyrex. So the participants, I'm requesting all the participants and all the dignitaries to join DCRC, and we are grateful for helping you. Thank you so much, sir, to taking out time from your busy schedule. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, Shukla sir, for providing me the opportunity. Thank you very much.